Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Indian Mom Cooking. So today's recipe is peas pulao. Very simple and easy, at the same time very delicious, and it's a great option for your kids' lunchbox. And I made this peas pulao in cooker. So let's get started with the recipe. So the ingredients are very minimal and you can make in with it 15 to 20 minutes. So let's get started. So the cooker that I'm using is Prestige steel cooker. It's 5-liter cooker. So now I'm starting off with ghee. I'm just adding 2 tablespoons of ghee and also 1 tablespoon of oil. You can add any oil of your choice. I'm adding your refined oil and let them get heated up. So to this we are going to add the whole garam masala. Starting off with 2 cloves, 1 inch cinnamon, 1 star anise and 1 inch cinnamon, 1 few jadikai and few kalpasi and 1 green cardamom. Make sure to keep the flame on medium and cook this for about 1 minute or until they release their aroma. Give it a good stir. And I have sliced onion into julienne. So this is about 1 big size onion. Just give it a good stir. And I'm also adding 5 slitted green chili. So here I'm not going to add any red chili powder. So the only spiciness comes from green chili. So I'm adding 5 slitted green chili. And again give it a good stir. And close the lid and cook for about 2 to 3 minutes or until the onions become softer. Make sure to keep the flame on medium. And it's been 2 to 3 minutes. Now the onions are softened. And now it's time to add about freshly pounded ginger garlic paste. I'm adding here about 1 tablespoon. So freshly grinded ginger garlic paste gives you a lot of aroma and flavor to the entire dish. And again I'm going to close it and cooking for about 2 to 3 minutes. So now the raw smell of the ginger garlic paste has gone. Now it's time to add about a handful of green peas. Or about 1/2 cup of green peas. So I'm using frozen peas here and add required salt for the peas pulao and again give it a good stir. And now I'm going to add about a handful of mint leaves that are roughly chopped. Again, this gives you a lot of flavor to the peas pulao. Again, give it a good stir. And I'm going to add about basmati rice. It's about 1 glass of basmati rice. I've washed it and soaked it for about 10 minutes. You can soak the basmati rice before you start cooking. And I've added the entire basmati rice. This is about 1 glass of basmati rice. And I will be showing you the glass in which I measured the basmati rice. And again give it a good stir and be gentle while stirring. You do not want to break the rice. At this stage we are going to add coconut milk. So here we are not going to use any water. We are going to use only coconut milk. So I'm adding about 1 1/2 glass of coconut milk in which I measured one glass of basmati rice. So this is a glass in which I measured basmati rice. So I've added one glass of basmati rice. To that, I'm going to add about 1.5 glass of coconut milk. Again, give it a good stir. Check for seasoning. If you want more salt, you can add at this stage. So I found these green chilies are too spicy. So I just took off 2 green chilies out of it, because each and every green chilies differs from the spiciness. So I'm just taking 2 green chilies out. So check for your spiciness and then you can take out or you can keep it. So now at this stage, let's wait until bubbles appears all over the place. So as you all can see, it has started to boil. So now at this stage, you can very well close the lid and cook this piece pulao. So I'm going to keep 2 whistles on medium flame and 1 whistle on high flame and leave it until the pressure comes down. So yes, 2 whistles on medium flame and 1 whistle on high flame. So yes, I hope you all like this recipe. Green peas pulao is ready to be served and just garnishing with from freshly chopped coriander leaves. And you can give this for your kids' lunchbox or for your husband's lunchbox. And it's very easy recipe and at the same time tastes delicious. I'm just adding some roasted cashew nuts. You can very well add it at the starting stage. And I'm just adding few roasted cashew nuts. You can very well add it at the starting stage. And that is all. This is how I make peas pulao. And finally, I'm just garnishing with some freshly chopped coriander leaves. Please do try this recipe and let me know in the comment section. And I will all catch you in my next video. Until then, stay happy. And the link of the cooker is given in the description box. You can very well go and check it out.